The snow's got a bite out here.
Nobody. That's who.
Everyone all right?
All right, Outlander. You want to talk about our deal with Berggrund? Let's talk.
That's done. You three are pretty handy in a fight.
Thanks, I guess. Not that we needed your help. We are doing just fine without you.
That's not the way Berggrund tells it. He says you tried to settle up with him using a shattered Thunderjaw heart.
What? That's an exaggeration. It was only broken in two.
Urkai, we don't have time for this. Come on, boys, back to the hunt. We still need two more of Berggrund's components.
What's the rush?
We want out of these lands as soon as possible. That's all you need to know.
Why are you leaving the Cut?
Well, we could go back to Bannor. Let Anakut slit our throats.
By the blue light, Urkai. Why don't you just write our story in the snow for any passing hunter to read?
We had a dispute with the chieftain of our old Werak. We thought someone else should have been in charge. He disagreed.
It seemed like a good time to move on, so we are traveling to the Sundom.
From here to the Sundom, it's a long trip.
Seems worth it. Sometimes survival is about knowing when to leave and where to go.
Yeah, and in this case, survival means us getting as far away as we can from Bonor. We've seen enough red snow.
What's the plan once you get there? What will survival be about then?
Look, all that matters is that we get there. And to do that, we need shards. So if you'll excuse us.
So this Thunderjaw heart you brought Bergrin...
Let me ask you this, all right? Why would it matter that the heart was broken into two pieces? Can't you just stick it back together?
Of course you can't just stick it back together.
I just meant...
Oh, I bet that scam artist Osram could. He just wants to send us on another stupid errand.
Oh, he's not so bad. I like Bergrin.
Like him? Tulamot, he sent us out in the snow to nearly die under the feet of a Thunderjaw, and...
Boys, shut up! Ugh! Every time someone brings up that stupid heart.
I've got the Scorcher Claw Bergrin was asking for. That only leaves the Stalker Sinew and the Snap Maw Fang.
You should hold on to it. You're coming along to the next hunt after all, aren't you?
I suppose somebody's got to keep you three out of trouble.
Fine. I guess you'll have to tag along then. But don't start thinking you're one of us. The Bloody Snowdrifts aren't accepting new hunters.
Bloody Snowdrifts? That's what you want to call our Werak?
Yeah, it's not great to die.
Well, it's not like your names are any better.
You. We're headed northwest, to the ruins near Hollow Hall. We'll be waiting. Thank you. The old ones.
No, 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 no.
much for being careful.
Thank you.
Won't be hard to sell a check like this. Long day. And a longer night ahead, most likely. I'll do what I... you fistful of losing is worth braving, Colt. Here's the herd. Everyone ready?
Are you joking? We were born ready. Let's go get them, Flaming Skulls!
Nope. That's awful.
It is a pretty bad name. Good effort, Dorokai.
Forget it. Let's just go kill something.
like we did it!
Almost too easy.
I don't know about you three, but I feel better. Aloy, did you get that component?
That's another card down. One more and you'll have what you need to pay off Burgrund.
Starting to feel real, you know. I'm starting to believe we're really gonna get out of here. Honestly, I wasn't sure we'd survive a week without Nekoni. But here we are.
Who's Nekoni?
She was a friend of ours. She challenged the chieftain for control of our... of the Werak.
She didn't make it.
No. If you're gonna tell this story, tell it true. She was murdered. Is this why you left Ben-Hur? Because of this business with Nekoni and your chieftain?
Onakut knew Nekoni was our mentor, our friend. We couldn't stay.
That final night, we snuck back to camp, packed what we could, and left.
Like cowards.
What are we to Tai? We are Banuk, aren't we? Survive and prevail. That's what we do.
It's not what she did. Nekoni challenged the chieftain. Why?
Onikut wrapped himself in power and authority the way some people wrap themselves in furs. If you were willing to fawn over him and sing false songs to him, you might get a spot on the best hunts. The Werak split into two. Those willing to lick the bottoms of Onikut's feet, and the rest of us, waiting for things to get better.
Until me.
She was the best and bravest of us. She was the one who took a stand.
What happened? How did you lose Nekoni?
She challenged the chieftain to a hunting competition. Onikut, damn him. He wasn't nearly the hunter Nekoni was. But who comes back to the camp after the trial? Onikut, grinning like a snap maw, crowing, "Oh, where's little Nekoni?"
We tracked Nekoni through the woods. Found her not far from the trailhead.
With her damn neck snapped.
I don't want to remember her like that. Sometimes that memory... that's all I can think of. I'm sorry, Tai. It sounds like she meant a lot to you. To all of you. I'm sorry for what you've been through.
It's nice to be heard. Thank you, Aloy.
Look, it doesn't matter, okay? What happened in Ben-Hur is buried in Ben-Hur. What matters now is what happens in the Sundom. That's where the burning turkeys are gonna make a name for ourselves, right?
Oh, the burning turkeys? Seriously?
It rolls off the tongue.
Sort of like vomit.
So, where to next?
There's a lake just west of here. Seems like a good place to find a snapmaw fang. We'll meet you there.
If you beat us there, just wait by the campfire. We'll be along.
I can't feel my... feel much of anything in this. Figure of some strange animal.
Americanus, the magnificent American black bear, brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Beautiful. How fierce you must be.
You never even felt the cold, did you?
If he hadn't preserved you, would anyone even know you'd disappeared?
I hate to interrupt.
Oh, I... Yes. Hello, I... Oh, an outlander at the Shrine of Forgotten Beasts. Welcome. I'm Enjuk.
Aloy. The Shrine of... what?
When the old world still breathed, a great man built a tiny totem to this beast and stored the visage inside. When the totem is placed on the pedestal, the animal is painted onto the empty air, and the beast lives again. Well, almost.
There are 7 pedestals. Where are the other 6 figurines?
I found this one in the wilds, remembered the indentations in the pedestals here, and saw how they matched the base of the totem. But as you say, it's 1 of 7, isn't it? The great Montana Recreations must have made more, but Time has scattered them.
So these totems, the images they show are of animals that no longer exist. They're gone, like the old ones.
So it seems. To think such magnificent creatures are lost to us, that we never even knew they were here. We rely as much on beasts as we do on machines. For food, for warmth, but do we study them with the same fervor? Yeah, I do. For example, I have this theory about foxes. Why do foxes have red fur? Think about what they eat.
Meat?
Raw meat. Bloody meat. See? Natural causation. Logical connections. It only makes sense.
You've thought a lot more about foxes than I have. You said a great man made these figurines?
Indeed. He was, I believe, a student of the natural world. Like me. But surpassing my abilities 1,000 times over. The great Montana recreations. Perhaps the finest natural scholar the old world ever produced. His voice claims responsibility for the totems, the vessels for the knowledge he accumulated. I share his desire to understand the beasts, to catalog their behaviors and preserve their images. I like to flatter myself that I'm an apprentice of sorts, carrying on his work. Someday, perhaps, if I am persistent, I can earn his name, Enjuk Recreations.
I found some of those animal figurines you like.
Thank you, Aloy. Look, such form and poise they have upon their pedestals. Montana Recreations truly captured their legacy.
I should get going.
Of course, of course. I've taken up so much of your time already. But I don't suppose you could keep an eye out for more figurines?
If I run across any, I'll bring them your way.
Ursus Arctos, the menacing grizzly bear, brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Those claws. claws look like they could rip someone in half.
Perhaps in its youth, but you heard Montana Recreations. He said it's grizzled, old. Its hunting days are behind it.
Ursus Arctos, the menacing grizzly bear. Brought to you by Montana Recreations. Odocoileus virginianus, the majestic mule deer. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Not built like a predator, but perhaps it needed those horns to take down its prey in the absence of sharp fangs.
Canis lupus, the enigmatic gray wolf. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Could it be that these wolves and our foxes are the same somehow? Perhaps after hundreds of winters... No. No, that's ridiculous.
Alsus Alsus, the noble moose. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
The horns grow like trees. Of course, this moose used those bizarre growths to blend in with its forest home.
Ursus Americanus, the magnificent American black bear. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
How would you like to find yourself cornered by that thing?
I suspect I'd like it very much indeed. What a beautiful beast you were!
Visitor Center's a bust. I'm recording the strategic and operational value at roughly 0 point squat. No reason we shouldn't pat the staff onto a vert and send them back to Nowheresville as soon as the gates are locked. Enjoy basic income, ding-dongs.
Sign of them yet. Guess I'll just sit and wait. I was starting to worry about you three. Everything all right?
We took our time. After our last conversation, we had a lot to think about.
I can imagine. Just one more hunt, then your debt is paid and you three can make your way south. Ready?
Huntress, the Sunshine Snowshoes await your signal.
Horrible!
I'm almost impressed, Dulamok. Didn't think you could come up with a name worse than Burning Turkeys.
Well, I liked it. Let's hunt.
I can smell the new day on the wind. of these.
Thank you.
proper goodbye, huh?
There. That's the last of Bergren's parts. Looks like you three are out of debt.
For now. Until Orkai breaks something else.
It was one time!
You make a nice shaman, Aloy. Thanks for lending a hand. Maybe we'll meet you in the Sundom sometime.
Once you get to the Sundom, what then? What's the next step?
We hunt like Nekoni wanted to hunt.
Nekoni had big dreams. A werak in which everyone pulls their weight and takes care of each other. No shamans, no chieftains, no need to pry the power out of anybody's hands.
Sounds like a lot of work.
But worth it, I think. And a fitting tribute to Nekoni. We can become the werak she always wished for.
You won't have me to strip your kills now. Are you three gonna be all right?
Doesn't look that hard, really. We'll be fine.
Great. He washes three successful harvests and he's suddenly a shaman.
When you get to Song's Edge, talk to Bergrind. If he can't teach you himself, he'll know someone who can.
Sure. And I bet he charges us for the introduction.
Thank you, Aloy. I'm sure we'll figure it out.
I guess this is goodbye. How does it feel, putting Banuk lands behind you?
The only thing I would have missed is already gone.
Let all those rotten Bonor suck-ups freeze to death.
It's a little much, Urkai, don't you think? That's strange. What is it to be Banuk after Banur forsakes you? How do we decide who we are? How about you, Aloy? Who do you think we are? What will you remember of us?
Look around. You've taken down more machines since you left Banur than some hunters take down in a year.
Shattered hearts and all, right, Orkai?
It wasn't shattered.
But you took down a Thunderjaw to get that heart, didn't you?
We did.
So, silly suggestion. But what if we were the Shattered Hearts?
You know, I actually like it.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Thank you, Aloy, for seeing us for who we are.